Hello friends, today we are going to talk about the second part of cyber attacks. In this video we will see the difference between DOS and DDoS attack. Let's kick it off with DOS. A denial of service attack is a security threat that occurs when an attacker makes it impossible for legitimate users to access computer system, networks or services. Attackers in these type of attacks typically flood web servers with traffic that overwhelms the victim resources, makes it difficult for anyone else to access them. Restarting a system will usually fix an attack that crashes a server, but flooding attacks are more difficult to recover from. Recovering from a distributed DOS attack, in which attack traffic comes from a large number of sources, is even more difficult. DOS attack typically fall into two categories. Buffer overflow attacks, an attack type in which a memory buffer overflow can cause a machine to consume all available hard disk space, memory or CPU time. This form of exploit often results in sluggish behavior, system crashes or other bad server behaviors, resulting in denial of service. Flood attacks, by saturating a targeted server with an overwhelming amount of traffic, a malicious actor can oversaturate server capacity, resulting in denial of service. For most DOS flood attacks to be successful, the malicious actor must have more available bandwidth than the target. Other attacks include ping of death, teardrop, smurf attack, ping flood, and syn flood. DOS attack executed from one place. Let's say we have a web server and this server belongs to a company that sells its product on the internet. And over here we have a couple of buyers who are checking the company's website, looking at the products. And there is someone who wants to execute an attack on company's web server. Let's say he is going to attack the server for some bad reason. Maybe he doesn't like the company or product. So what really happens? Attacker is going to use his computer and malicious software to attack this server and flood it with fake data traffic to interrupt its service. DOS attack comes from one source. Normally, this type of attack is easy to deal with, simply rebooting the computer or closing the connection where the attack is coming from. So it's not an issue. But the problem occurs when the attack comes from many sources, which is a DDoS attack. Distributed denial of service attacks are those in which multiple systems disrupt the traffic of a targeted server by attacking the victim with messages or connection requests. The attackers can slow the server, crash it, or even shut it down. Preventing these legitimate computers from accessing the server resources, which results in denial of service because the server is already preoccupied in dealing with the DDoS attack. In a typical DDoS attack, attacker exploits a vulnerability in one computer system, making it the DDoS master. The attack master system identifies other vulnerable systems and gains control of them by infecting them with malware. A computer under control of an intruder is known as a zombie or bot. Attacker creates a command and control server to command the network of bots, also called a botnet. A botnet is an army of infected devices to execute a DOS attack. The person in control of a botnet is called a botmaster. Once botnet is assembled, attacker can use the traffic generated by the infected devices to attack the target server and knock it offline. When the server is targeted by the botnet, each bot sends infected traffic to the target server to eat up all its resources, including CPU memory and network bandwidth. Every bot is a legitimate internet device, so separating the attack traffic from normal traffic can be difficult. DOS attack mainly target online shopping website, online casino business that provide online services. One of the biggest DDoS attacks happened in New Zealand in 2020. Attackers targeted New Zealand Exchange, forcing it to go offline for several days. It has mainly three types: network-centric attacks, protocol attacks, and application layer. So, how to prevent such attacks? Well, ongoing security assessment, network security controls, patch management, email phishing testing, user awareness, and proactive network monitoring and alerting can help to minimize DOS attacks. The bottom line is DOS and DDoS attacks often take advantage of vulnerabilities in networking protocols. Alright, thanks for watching this video on a comparison between DOS and DDoS. Please subscribe for the next part.